the flex tree is probably one of the greatest things that's happened to both horses and riders. I know personally, my horse is very, very sensitive. He gets easily sore in the back, I think because the saddle, a rigid saddle tends to bridge on him. The first time I tried a flex tree on him, he felt so different to me that I've never ridden him in anything since. But I really enjoyed going to the Circle Y factory and actually seeing saddles being made at every step of the way, starting with how the trees were made. And I discovered the flex tree is a lot more complicated than it actually sounds.
Well, it really is. And you know, the flex tree, there's all different types of flex in our industry. What we have is actually the flex two. And the tree is just not flexible. So the whole technology of the tree and how it's put together and how the skirt is made, all those combine to make a great saddle with good flexibility and good fit for the horse's back.
Mm-hmm. So is all of this tree made from flexible materials or what? What exactly, it kind of looks like different stuff here.
Yeah, that's a great question. I had the guys make this up for us so we can look at and kind of demonstrate what the saddle looks like. This is an average flex tree, and it might even be in one of your saddles, this type of tree that's in there. But really, the only thing that's flex on it are the bars. And so we have a combination of two different products. We have a low density and a high density polyethylene is what it's called. And so because
oh, yeah, that's
of that,
a lot harder
yeah, this
than...
is very stiff and uh-huh. it's tapered down. And so really the flex that we get is in the bar tips, in the front and
that's
in the back.
That's where the horse really benefits from opening.
Yeah, and so then that is actually attached. You have your swirl and your cantle that's actually made out of wood. It's reinforced with fiberglass.
Uh-huh.
And so it's a very strong material and has this Durahyde coating on it in order to give it strength and make it waterproof. So these saddles are, you know, traditional rawhide, especially with trail riders, when it gets wet, it gets all loose,
spongy.
Then it constricts again, and over a period of time, it could actually warp the tree. Well, this Durahyde makes the saddle where it's waterproof. Then it's got an iron horn on it that we covered as well, so you could, you know, you could pony your horse or drag something out of the woods, not have any problems with it.
Hmm.
And this ground seat is probably part of the greatest technology. It keeps the saddle from overflexing, helps with the twist in the tree, and helps it also to give it some rock. And so the ground seat is very important. This is a very durable fiberglass ground seat that we put in it. So all this together makes a really nice fitting saddle for a lot of horses.
And you mentioned something about how it fits into the skirts and that actually sort of becomes part of the tree.
Yeah, the way this saddle is built, the skirt that we put on it, it actually has a closed cell sponge inside of it. It's not all leather. And so what happens when the horse heats up, the saddle actually becomes more flexible in the tips, in the front and in the back. And so so it becomes, as the actually, the longer you ride it, the more flexible it becomes, and actually the better it conforms and fits. It doesn't fit to extremes. We have different tree widths. And so this is not going to become wider, and it's not going to break down and all that stuff. And so if you need a wide tree, you need a wide tree. What you try to do is you try to make the core of the saddle fit. And in this saddle, if it fits close, it actually will adjust and help it fit better.
Actually, now that you mention it, when I look at the saddle I ride in, the Monarch, which I designed, and is a flex two tree, you can almost see this portion of the tree. It's kind of covered with leather, and it flares out a little bit. Really, really gives a lot of freedom to the horse's shoulders.
It does do that. And one thing I want to kind of talk about is our saddles. You know, saddles are designed to hold a certain amount of weight. All saddles are. Not
no
just
matter
the flex
what kind
saddle.
Of tree
it doesn't matter
it
what kind of tree it is. It has a weight limit. And so typically what you're trying to do in a saddle is disperse about 2 pounds per inch. And so on a typical 16-inch saddle, the bar is much smaller. And so it can hold about 230, 250 pounds, depending on how you position your weight. And so the longer the tree, what happens is you move this cantle back a little bit, so you make the bar longer. And so,
so
the
you can
longer
take more
it
weight.
Is, it could take more weight.
Sure.
In today's industry, we have some great saddle pads. So not only do you have the dispersion of the weight on the saddle, but you have pads that can absorb the weight also. And that really helps disperse the weight and help with saddle fit as well.
So a heavier rider would probably be riding in a bigger seat anyway. And that, so this is a 16. If you go to a 17 or even an 18-inch saddle, those can carry more weight.
It carries more weight and it's proportional. So let's say an 18-inch saddle with a typical bar can hold about 280 pounds, give or take. But even if you weigh a little more than that, a good saddle pad can help absorb some of that pressure and still make that saddle useful for the type of riding you're doing.
Sure. And I mean, it's logical anyway that a bigger rider is going to need more room in the saddle. So,
yeah. And one thing to say with that, when you do get a saddle that long, you have to make sure you have a back long enough to handle it.
Mm-hmm.
Sometimes you typically
the
get
horse's
a shorter.
Back.
Yeah, the horse's back. Yeah. Sometimes you typically get a longer tree and a shorter back, then the saddle mm-hmm. might bridge. Mm-hmm. So you have to make the saddle fit the horse and the type of riding you're doing as well.
Yeah. Good. Well, one thing I notice, and I tell people, people try out my saddle a lot for the very first time, and I remember the very first time I rode in a flex tree. As a rider, I could actually feel the difference. After the first one or two rides, you don't notice it, but at first, you kind of feel the shock absorption.
Yeah, yeah. And all that does is, the whole idea, absorb pressure, disperse it, make it more comfortable for the horse, in turn makes it more comfortable for you.
Yeah, I'll say.